everyone, every living being performs some life process to survive. In this process, some take place continuously throughout our life. Some of them takes place without our consent also. And among them, one is respiration. Today, we discuss about mechanism of respiration in human beings. We know that breathing is the process of inhale and exhale of air. So the organ mainly participated in breathing is lungs. How the respiration takes place? To know, you have to observe your chest for some time. You observe that our chest part moves forward and backward, little bit only. So this is the action of the lungs. We feel what happening here when we breathe air. So the chest cavity is getting slightly bigger, and when we breathe out the air, our chest cavity return to its regular size. So this is what happening inside our chest cavity. So the lungs are filling with air, and lungs have no capacity to fill them with air and push out the air outside. So what are helping in the process of respiration? The parts are helping in respiration process are chest wall muscles and diaphragm. Chest wall muscles is made up of ribs, muscles and skin, and the ribs are attached to the spinal cord and they are arranged in a particular angle. So the starting ribs are smaller in size, and when we move to the downward, they are extends in size. So this particular angle of arrangement helps in process of respiration. So this structure helps when we inhale the air, the chest wall moves up and expands. This causes to increase the volume of our chest cavity. Ribs and muscles together work to expand the chest cavity in the process of respiration. Next, diaphragm. Diaphragm is flexible flattened muscle which is lies below the chest cavity. Diaphragm separates the abdominal cavity from chest cavity. Diaphragm in a normal position, it's a dome-like shape. So when we inhale air, it pulls to the downward and it takes the flattened like structure. With this, the volume of chest cavity increases, and due to this, the pressure inside the lungs decreases. Due to that, the outside air rushes into our lungs. This is known as inspiration or inhale. Next, the action takes place in reverse order. The chest wall lowers inward and diaphragm relaxes to into the dome shape. So with these two actions, the chest cavity decreases and the pressure increases inside the lungs, and that pressure push out the air outside. So this is known as exhale or expiration. Totally, to inhale air, the ribs, diaphragm, both are helping, and in the expiration process also, they are coming back to their normal sizes, and then the expiration is taking place. In the process of respiration, In men, the diaphragm helps mostly, and in women, the ribs are helpful in process of respiration. Observe the following video and you understand clearly what happens in the chest cavity while respiration taking place. Breathing pattern shows some difference in particular times. What situations affect our breathing? So observe your own breath, that is slow and shallow when we are taking rest, and it is deeper and faster when we exercise hardly or running. Breathing either slow or faster, they are coordinated with movement by movement to body for supply of oxygen and removal of carbon dioxide. Total breathing process is controlled by some nerves. So with the help of nervous system, the total process taking place. Nerves connect the respiratory muscles to the brain. When they cut, it affects our breathing. So when they cut, all movements of breathing stop at once and it leads to the death. So we have to understand that so breathing process may change in particular situations. Gaseous exchange. Gaseous exchange takes place within the lungs by diffusion process. Carbon dioxide present in the blood is exchanged with oxygen in the alveoli. Lungs are filled with tiny air sac-like structures known as alveoli. They are numerous in number and they are surrounded by capillaries that are very numerous. The capillaries are collects the blood from the heart, which is dark red in color, that is having carbon dioxide with them, and it reaches to the alveoli. Alveoli having the oxygen rich air, and whenever the capillaries reaches to the alveoli, the carbon dioxide in the blood exchanged with oxygen in the alveoli. Now the blood leaves the carbon dioxide and takes the oxygen from the alveoli. After that, the blood changes to the bright red in color, which is having rich oxygen with blood. Now that oxygen rich blood, which is bright red in color, flows to the and pumped to the all parts of body, and the carbon dioxide which is present in the alveoli, that is pushed to outside in the process of expiration. Now one question raises here. The composition of inhaled and exhaled air is different or same? Now observe the following table shows approximate values of inhaled and exhaled air.